China pushing back against the visit of U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin to the Philippines. The Chinese embassy says America's military posture in the region escalates tension and undermines regional peace and stability. The embassy claims Austin smeared Beijing during his visit to Manila to advance an alleged anti-China political agenda. The embassy urges the Philippines to resist from supposedly being taken advantage of and being dragged into troubled waters. During Secretary Austin's visit, the Philippines granted the U.S. greater access to military bases. Washington will be given access to 4 more locations under the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA. This would allow the U.S. to position military equipment and rotate its troops in a total of 9 military bases controlled by the Philippines. The 4 new sites have yet to be announced.
The bilateral meeting we held today will further strengthen our nation's collaborative efforts in addressing pressing security threats. We shall continue to work towards maintaining a stable, rule-based, open, and inclusive Indo-Pacific region. Along with partner countries, we strongly oppose any unilateral action or attempt to disrupt current world order and share the same views that all countries should resolve any issue peacefully and adhere to the international law, particularly the United Nations Conventions of the Law of the Sea, or UNCLOS.
But Secretary Austin clarified EDCA is not about establishing a permanent base in the Philippines.
EDCA is not about permanent basing here in the Philippines. It's about providing access that allows us to increase our training opportunities with our partners, our allies here. It's about having the ability to respond in a more effective fashion as we're collectively faced with humanitarian assistance issues or natural or disaster response issues. And so this is an opportunity to increase our effectiveness, increase interoperability. It is not about permanent basing, but it is a big deal. It's a really big deal in that, it gives us, provides us the opportunity again to interact a bit more in an effective way.
For Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, it is in the best interest of the Philippines to renew and strengthen its alliance with the U.S. He also sees several benefits following the visit of America's defense chief.
3 benefits that I see. Number one is interoperability. This is very important, both military and both disaster preparedness, because I've seen this. And when there's a calamity, you need external help. Yes. And America is always one of the most ready countries. It balances geopolitics in the region. And that's also important, not only for the Philippines, but also for the region.
As for Senator Francis Tolentino, he is in favor of what he called upgrades in the defense and security cooperation between Manila and Washington, as long as they are anchored on solid constitutional foundations.